even Elizabeth was 100 years, and she's experiencing this morning thing that despite all the joys that she had in her life, there is not one thing that she could compare to this morning that would describe her meeting with Jesus Christ. So we rejoice in that. And we rejoice in her life. And we rejoice that now there is no more pain, no more sorrow, no more grief for Elizabeth, but complete joy. That's our life now. That's the calling of every one of us who were born into this world. And we should never forget it. We should never postpone seeking the mercy of God and His pardon and His love. We should anticipate with joy and fulfillment the time that the Lord will say, come, possess the kingdom prepared for you. Did you ever think when our Lord described the last judgment, how beautifully He made that be described, how the Lord would receive those of us who were good and those of us who might not be so good? Possess the kingdom prepared for you. And then listen to me specifically for salvation. Because when I was hungry, you gave me to eat. When I was thirsty, you gave me to drink. When I was naked, you clothed me. When I was in prison, you visited me. And the good people will say, Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or naked or in prison or ill? Then the blessed God said these words, as long as you did it to one of these, the least of my brethren, you did it to me. So it's not heroic acts, Lord, although they may be. It's not heroic acts that win us heaven. It's the ordinary things that we do to each other, for each other, every day of our life. And I was this morning as a young man, for example, who spent two very valuable years in Honduras, helping the needy and the hungry and the deprived in Honduras. And because of that experience and his service to others, his heart and soul were opened up to all these people. And he teaches to lead them. That's the kind of service, maybe not as great as that, but the ordinary things of faith, kindness and love, and patience that we show to one another. Reaching out with the smile, reaching out with the hand of friendship, reaching out in unselfishness, helping those who are less fortunate than we are. That's the recipe for heaven. Some people think that it would be impossible to get there. You know, some young people say to me, no, I'll never get there. And I know several young men and women whom I'm absolutely sure would get there because of the manner of life they live, what they do in their lives, in their young lives, and service, and so forth. Many wonder if they'll be bored because after a million years without this God, one would think, well, you're going to be bored. And some men especially would like to know if the Vikings would be playing on Sunday afternoons up there, or whether they could spend a 3.5-4 hours in front of their TV looking at their favorite team, or their favorite beer would be served. For me, it was very simple as a child, since we were so poor. My idea of heaven was as plenty of ice cream. And so we all have our own ideas, but they're very, very, very short of the ideas that our blessed God has in store for each one of us. Elizabeth lived that life, awaiting that encounter with our blessed God. She worked on a farm. It wasn't easy. It wasn't easy in those days, for sure. give you the gift of faith. And she would say to you, I don't care what you will achieve in this world. I don't care what position you reach in this life. If you don't possess a strong living faith, you have nothing. And so when you want to revere your grandmother or your great-grandmother, say to yourself, how would she react to my idea today as a young person? What she treasured the most, the I equally treasure. Because the world